Hello everyone. So I'm testing a bit Twitch. It's my first live ever on Twitch. So yeah, I'm doing some tests. I will see if everything works too smoothly. Essentially, I will do tonight. I don't have a lot of time, so I think I will just do 30 minutes or 1 hour of exploring what I can do for my shader. But yeah. There will be a longer live stream on Saturday, and probably every Saturday, Saturday night, at around this hour, a bit later, at 21 p. I mean, it's 9 p.m. On Saturday, so 9 p.m. Paris time. I will do that, but today I will just do a shader because that's what I've been doing for the past. We are already 26 or 27, I don't remember, but yeah, that's what I've been doing for the past days, and I've been sharing them on Twitter here. So yeah, if anyone is watching right now, please also comment so I can just check if things are working, because it's the first time ever I do this Twitch. We should see comments in the stream itself, so that should be in place already. So yeah, I've been doing that since the beginning of our lockdown in France. I'm just sharing every day, trying to write a shader every day. So what a shader is some piece of code that runs in the GPU and that executes some visual effects. You can look at everything I did here. So right now, I should have actually showed what I did recently. So, I think I started on 25. I always wanted to do that. That's Mandelbrot. And Mandelbrot is a pretty famous fractal. And in fact, that's the code here that we have. It's super incredible that in a small formula like that make it. Wow, that's lagging a bit. I think my computer is having difficulties with all the CPU and GPU challenge I'm putting on my computer is a bit heavy, but that's fine. Anyway, it's a pretty interesting formula. Where basically it's just a loop. We iterate a certain amount of time to accumulate a point. And then based on the divergence, because basically it's a Mandelbrot set, so if you look on Wikipedia you can find more information about it, but essentially the idea is you split there is two cases, either the either it diverge or either it converge to a finite it loops I don't even know how you say it in English, but your suite, I don't know how you say it in English anyway. There is some mathematical criteria to determine if you are inside or outside, and then we can actually render that and use the iteration of the loop to give a color. That's usually the classical way to make things nice, look nice, but essentially you are either inside or outside, and that's essentially these two cases. So I've been browsing a bit some other famous fractals that are based on that Mandelbrot, and I felt yesterday or this morning I found a really interesting one, which is called Burning Ship, I think it's called like that. Why is it saying that? Come on, Google. Oops, what I clicked. So anyway, it's quite incredible we have this so if anyone is watching right now, please confirm in using the chat. That would be great, because I can type myself. Hello there. Is it displaying on my stream? Actually, it's not displaying. Oh, it is. Okay, it's just with the white, we don't see it, man. So yeah, let's try that. And it looks like it's not so far from Mandelbrot. In fact, it's just... it's just applying an absolute... like all the negative need to go positive, so is it absolute? Abs, anyway. The absolute value, so I think it's just here. So essentially P, or maybe P equal abs of P, maybe that's it. But essentially if you look at the formula, here we are multiplying by himself, so it's never gonna be negative, so it's already an absolute, so it's, I guess, only here. I could do abs here, but that's the same. Yeah, I could do abs. So yeah, anyway, I was just saying that on day 25 I did that, on day 26 I continue on my fractal ideas, and yeah, actually, I had some fun yesterday about that. I was just randomly playing with that formula, trying different things, and I've played with changing a bit, using cosinus and sinus and the time. The parameters are a bit changing over time, which have this nice initial, I really like, especially the initial effect where you see some islands, I mean some parts that split out, and that's what I call fumes, because it's like fading away. Yeah, it's quite interesting the beginning, but then the way it evolves after is a bit more boring, but still a bit trippy. So yeah, I think I'm a bit stuck in a in a fractal loop now. I don't know how many days I will do fractals, but I still want to continue doing fractals. So let's try this. I'm gonna save again, and maybe we are going to switch to another. Yeah, I'm back, sorry. It's kids. That's a bit the problem of doing that in the middle of the week. So that's why I'm gonna do it quick. I'm not gonna stay too long, but yeah, I'm just gonna play. It seems like it's just absolute. So I'm trying to do the burning ship fractal, and it seems to be it. It seems to be that formula, or maybe I'm not that sure, so I'm gonna stop all the weird rotation and zoom. Why are we zooming? Oh yeah, that was for the other day, so I'm just gonna undo that. Undo all of that. Yeah, I mean, we know the concept, just rotating, shifting. So I need to unzoom maybe. Is this the burning chip? The burning chip. I don't know. it looks like it doesn't look like it's a burning ship, but so maybe I got something wrong. Interesting. Oh, maybe I need to actually absolute the. It's not that equivalent, in fact. Didn't change. Yeah, it is equivalent. It didn't change anything, so maybe it's not that formula. It's still to the square of. Oh, it's a plus, it's not a minus, maybe? Okay, is there some explanation? I think I shouldn't go in French article, I should go in English, there's more details. Okay, because when you look at Mandelbrot set, the formula is exactly the same. It's just that there is no absolute. Yeah, z square plus c, here it's, it's actually not z, it's the reprojection of z. What does it mean for us? Alright. Okay, so there is pseudocode about that. And yeah, it's doing apps. It's doing an apps. Oh, it's two times. Plus y. So what's the code? Okay, plus x plus y. Okay, I need to do plus y. That's fine. So absolute of this. Alright, it's not that yet. Oh, and here it's doing plus. No, but that's already covered in here, I think. That's the init. Yes, that's the initial value, so there is no such p dot y. I think we got the formula right, it's just not exactly doing the same thing, or maybe I'm just not looking at the correct place, or maybe not applying the correct coloring of it. I guess we can try different things, different... Oh, that looks better now. I mean, yeah, I think we are not normalizing to the correct values when we do that. Let's change the palette because that's not really interesting yet. Okay. Oh yeah, I'm doing that, I think I should. Usually when the what's inside is black, so I might just do that as well. I think I'm gonna return minus one and just under the color. So let's call the float f. So the float is a it's a value from 0 to 1 when it's outside, and it's a value minus 1 when it's inside. So I think I need to switch on two cases. I don't remember which direction it is, but I think that's like something like that. So this will return 0 or 1 if it's negative or not, and then I can return the color of F using my palette, or just black. Black is 0, alright. That's it. It's not really, it's not beautiful at all for sure, but Yeah, we can maybe try just black and white for now. Later we can consider other coloring. Okay, so it needs to be 1 minus. So yeah, what I want to figure out is how to make look like this. And definitely seems like it's that shape, right? It's exactly that shape. I just don't have the correct transformation to see the big picture the same way it is rendered in that wiki page, but I can figure it out. So I can rotate. I can rotate to some value. Just need to figure it out. It's too much, or is it not enough? Right. So minus two. Oh, it's actually flipped. If we look at the wiki page, so I mean we can flip it. That's not a problem. How do we flip it? I mean, we can do that. Hello, Juan. Yes, is it displaying in the stream when you? Yeah, I guess it does. Hello, hello. I'm trying. It's the first time I ever do switch. So, yeah, with the ugly green. So I think I can. Oops, that's not it. Yeah, I can move that somewhere else. But anyway. All right, so I'm trying this burning sheep. Yeah, it seems like at least it's the correct formula, but oh yeah, I'm just seeing this part, but there's a bigger picture. So where is this ship that looks like the Titanic? It's crazy. It's exactly the Mandelbrot. It's just exactly like the Mandelbrot, but there's just this abs on top of the formula, so it's quite impressive with just changing a bit that, and that's a totally different fractal. Okay, so yeah, I was changing that value. So that should give more iteration for the loop, so probably a better precision, but since we do more loops, the value will, I mean, we will eject from the for loop a bit earlier, and that makes the value even more closer to one or even more closer to zero. So yeah, I should apply a different formula for having the same, if I want to see a bit better these shapes. Yeah, I need to stop doing this blur for now because that's not helping. Okay. So yeah, I mean I can do some pull of that value and change it a bit to. Okay, that's the other way. Yeah. So that's the pull of something 0.5 is just the square root anyway. But that will make the 0.5 value getting higher, so that's why We no longer have white, we have just a different normalization of the value. Anyway, let's just play with unzooming. So I guess I can add no, I can remove some zooming or divide by the time. But wow, it's too fast, I think. There's nothing. Where is everything? Where is everything? Where is this in that picture? Maybe it's inside somewhere and hidden in the fractal itself. A zoom in to the lower left of the burning ship fractal. To the lower left. Lower left. Or maybe here. Oh yeah, that's here. Oh my god. Oh yeah, okay. So I was not looking at the correct place. Okay, I need to offset to some center. I don't remember which side is this moving. Yeah, okay. Okay, so let's zoom in then, it's because there's nothing outside. Yeah, I have no chill music for you. Oh, is it just pi? Yeah, it's pi. 3.1, 3. Yeah, the rotation to do for. So we are actually flipping. We actually need to flip by pi, rotate by pi, minus pi. Pi is the same. Pi is not defined. Anyway, let me define it for you. Yeah, that's the Titanic. Titanic. So 10 plus time is just gonna smoothly zoom in. Oh my god, something is really slow on my computer, that's pretty bad. Oh, is this just a stream or? No, everything actually is fine. Okay, I don't know. I'm just giving my first Twitch test, so yeah, I want to zoom. Where should I zoom, in fact? Wow, that's so impressive. Like, how can there be such shapes with such a simple formula? And it looks like Notre Dame. Notre Dame on a ship. What? Ah, okay. Let's it's hard to figure out the good positioning. Oh, it's I'm not. Alright, I need to stop moving. That really looks like a ship that is sinking. or just yeah. A ship in the horizon. Okay, why is it granular like that? Is it just because I'm doing the mapping? Or maybe the precision of the loop? More iteration needed, maybe. Doesn't change anything. I don't know, that's weird. Maybe I should just remove that for now. I don't think it changed anything. So here it's just so we have our shader in this node, and actually I'm just stacking some other effects that I've defined in other places, which are shaders themselves. So you can compose shaders, which is really interesting for accumulating effects. And with GLReact, the library I wrote, you actually can compose it using React GSX, so you compose your shaders in a pretty easy way. And yeah, I think I have a blur with the 4 passes, so yeah, that's definitely blurring my my area, which the idea was actually to remove this effect. There is some glitch. I think it's due to imprecisions anyway, but or maybe moiré effect. But it's like when you zoom over time, even if you move really really slow like this, it's just gonna blink. It's just gonna glitch on. And I think I'm already doing a blur, so it's already fading away a bit. But if you just do a blur, you no longer will see that blink. Or actually, it's not enough. Actually, it's not really the blur that helps. It's another shader I have here, which is doing a fade between the previous state of the pixels. I mean, it's doing like your eyes when you look at a light and you close your eye, you still see a bit the light. So it's like a persistence effect. And if I put it a lot, actually it's we no longer see the blink. But if I will move, we will see it fade because. And it just takes time to print on the screen because it's just fading between two states and applying a new state each time, which also create its own glitches, like it have some traces if we move if we do a move like this, I guess. Yeah, and it's actually too much. So anyway, yeah, I'm inside the boat. So actually, this could be just a shader, and that's it. And maybe I can try another shader. So I have one time in advance because this is just today's shader. I have tomorrow to prepare as well. So yeah, that's pretty. That's an awesome shader. I wonder if we can tweak something like a tiny bit that will mess with the formula, and then just do an animation on that part of the world. That would be interesting. And I'm just in gray, white and black. Maybe I should try something else, I don't know. Should it just... Maybe I can offset the persistence by for making things false, like the making the some kind of I don't know how you say it, traîner like a traîner a trail. Alright, so. Oh yeah, that's not. Okay, I think it's actually on the. No, it's. Maybe that's what I wanted. Yeah, it's not. It's really interesting. Maybe if I use the cosinus of the time. Small. I need the time. Yeah, that's like a ship moving a bit on the sea. Yeah, not that much, but yeah, it's a bit shitty. It's not add colors, yeah. I mean, that's a style, we could be white, black and white. That's a possibility, but yeah, I think it's... It looks like I took a picture in like 100 years ago when the picture were pretty bad. Yeah, it's not, it's ugly. It's really ugly. I mean, we can keep a bit that, we can keep a bit that effect. We can make that parameter change over time. Alright, so yeah, I wanted to make it glitch a bit, so let's try to make it glitch. What's happening if I just do that? Oh god, oh, that's awesome. Wow. It looks like I'm rendering on a old screen, so where like an old screen where that takes time to refresh. Fractals are infinite, yes. Can you zoom and have it generating that? Can you zoom? Can't you zoom and have it regenerated that part anymore? I don't understand what you mean. But yeah, I mean we can. We can look at a lot of parts and zoom infinitely. There is just one problem, and maybe I can try to see that problem. we just need to kill the persistence because that's not good. One problem is that we are going to quickly reach the limits of running that in a shader that are the float precision. Yeah, it keep I generate 60 frames per second, which is dumb because there is just no changes. But yeah, if I don't know if I'm centered correctly to zoom. Yeah, I guess we have an interesting place here. Wow, that's like the Eiffel Tower. Yeah, we will be in a place here, but I need to offset a bit. I just gonna do that so I can undo. Right, so we can try to zoom inside that. Yeah, and I think we start seeing the issue, so. Hey, we are zooming 200 times, it's quite 2000 times. It's already quite a lot. So, we have not yet reached the floating issues. Is it actually animating? It's supposed to animate like time because I multiply by times. Okay, so here I don't know what is my value of, it's not moving, that's weird. I multiply by the time. I don't know. I guess I was using it. Okay, so it's pretty decent. Okay, it starts to make no sense to me. All right. Oh yeah, the time was not moving enough to actually see the motion. So yeah, here we see we affect because we start seeing pixels. And that means we no longer have enough in the representation of floats, in the precision of floats is not enough at that point. So we cannot represent the numbers anymore for covering the pixels of my canvas. That's quite a huge zoom. So yeah, we can still go quite far, but not that far, not infinitely. So yeah, I was doing this and it's quite impressive. Maybe that's just gonna be my effect of today. Like it's just the ship is just burning and that's a burning ship. And that's a joke on the name of the fractal itself because it's supposed to be static, but I'm just changing the formula. And just need to tweak the. So it needs to be red if it's burning. Maybe it's not fast enough, but still it can be interesting to. At the beginning you don't really see it, but at some point it's actually changing. So if in that direction it's doing that effect, like it's collapsing, what happens if I do the reverse? Let's start again from the beginning. We see other towers that's rising from the sea. Okay. Interesting. That's a bit mind-blowing. Like, can you figure out the math? Why would such formula create these shapes? It makes no sense. But that's the beauty of it. It's not the formula itself. It's the iteration of that formula, which at the end is just solving the problem of Mandelbrot. the variant of Mandelbrot, but that's the same concept that yeah, so that the mathematical term is bounded. So is a C bounded? And if it's bounded, it's gonna be inside. And if it's not bounded, it's gonna be outside. And then for coloring it, obviously, we just use how fast it went to the. Is it inside or outside, in fact? Oh yeah, when we reach max iteration, we are inside, so that's the black. And if it's not reaching. Oh yeah, that's the pseudo code here. It's not the same algorithm, it's a bit different. But here we are. Actually, if we are going to infinity, we skip before and we yeah. So anyway, it's all about determining if it's bounded or not, and so if C is bounded, it's inside, otherwise it's outside, and then you just have a simple, even simpler than the algorithm, in fact, like Mandelbrot set is just Z squared plus C. So it does not diverge, is bounded. I guess it's equivalent, not diverge. So it's if it diverge. It's outside. All right, so that's collapsing, but in another way, like the thing is going out of it. But yeah, I think I want it to collapse that way. So, wow, that's nice. Oh yeah, that's just perfect. Like it looks like it's the reflection of the on the water, you know, like this part. We have the top and we have the reflection of the water. Oh, okay. Yeah, except I would want it to be darker. I mean, yeah. Artistically, I would like it a bit. Okay, so and then it just fade away. There's nothing. That's pe just perfect. I don't know about the timing, but I think I need in dev mode. I should display the time in real time to see where how much time I've been before refreshing, so I can design them a bit more, a bit better. Okay, so yeah, we are like 5 seconds here, I guess. 10 seconds. So I think it needs to stick in 1 minute, like that's. Just two times faster. Okay, so we definitely need that blur to remove the glitch because of the animation. I think I want to shift to the top for making it sync because here it's moving up. So I need to offset that. I don't remember which direction. I think it's like that. Okay. I'm really curious what does the big picture looks like. So I'm just gonna quickly take a look at the other parts of the fractal in that case. Wow. It has been bigger, I think. It looks like it grows because I wasn't unzooming that much, or maybe. Just because I'm offsetting as well, so yeah, I don't know. I need to speed up the time. Nothing really changed much. Oh, okay. Yeah, it collapsed as well, slowly, but wow. That's interesting. it becomes a dot at the end. Will that make sense? Yeah, I mean, I'm adding a lot of y value over time, which means the y is going to appear here. It's gonna be lower and lower. That's why it disappears. So this is going to be lower than zero. And then the length is never going to be higher than two. So it's always going to be no. No, actually, it's gonna be outside. Why would it be outside? Oh, actually, the y is going to increase. So I guess that y value is gonna be big, and then the length of the. This is going to be lower than zero. Yeah, actually, it's gonna be in negative value as well. So the length is going to be quite big. So that's why it's going to be collapsed into just being always infinitely. Like never converging. All right, I think we are good. I think we are good. Yeah, we will. Why not adding coloring? Yeah, why not having some colors? I think that can be interesting. Oh, I missed some of your message. So you zoom in and. Éternel Louvien. Yeah, I wonder if the ship is somewhere inside the ship, but I doubt it happens. Why I doubt it? Because it looks like it's a big primitive at the beginning. I'm not sure we have a recursion of himself somewhere, but who knows? I mean, it's. Oh, there's another ship here? Or. Oh, it's a smaller one. Yeah, I guess it's covered in a bigger screen. Anyway. Alright, so yeah, I forked a bit the fractal we see on Wikipedia by just adding some just offsetting a bit y, and then we have an animation of the ship, the burning ship, which is the name of the original fractal, but now it's really burning because it's actually going to collapse, and we see it animating. So yeah, I think I can keep that. I'm gonna enable again the persistence effect, even though it's too much. Ah, it's fading in, fading out. Yeah, maybe faster. Yeah, that's better. It's like. Sounds like it should go up and not down because it's like the fumes of the burning ship. Yeah, but the problem is. I don't like the fact it's actually it looks like it's moving it's scrolling the image, but I think it is. It's because I should do something differently, maybe. Maybe I should. I don't know. Multiply that as well. No. I shouldn't mix. I should just sum, but if I sum, it's going to fade to white. Oh, it's actually applying on the alpha. Yeah. that effect too much. Yeah, that's okay, that's better. That looks like it's burning now. Yeah. I don't know if I really need the blur. I think I don't need blur. It's already too blurry with the persistence effect, so. It's nice because we are using the glitches of the initial shader itself to actually reuse it for making it look like it's moving up, so that helps the fact that there is some glitches. Okay, I'm not sure about the parameters of that, so maybe it shouldn't. Even if it's small, it's already quite. We see the effect, which is what we want. We don't need it to be too much blurry on the, especially not on the bottom part. But I like it. We see it fade in and out. Maybe that should be part of that. No. Yeah, okay, so that makes it faster if I increase. Yeah, I don't really like that. But it's nice moving left and right, I think. But faster. Not that fast. Just checking something. My computer is quite slow. I like the fact it's white and black. In fact, it's like it gives a bit an old fashioned picture. I could try sepia. What time is it in New York? It's 6 hours. Yeah. I have a friend in New York. Maybe he will join. Oh, it's like 3 p.m. All right. Anyway. Yeah, I think it's nice as is. Because I'm not sure I will really. Using a palette, it wouldn't be that looking good. Or the palette needs to be a bit simple, not the palette I have above. Because if I try it, it's not gonna be beautiful. But we can try. Okay, so let's make another color. F. And it was. Why would it be? Still interesting because we give another coloring for the non-black parts, whatever it's called. Like this weird towers on the ship doesn't. Yeah, but it becomes black as the thing is collapsing, which makes not a lot of sense. But yeah, I mean, you can just find another palette. And I think I need a generator of palettes that just gives you a lot of palettes and you just pick out of them because you're always playing with different values. Hello. So yeah, for those who just joined, everyone know Mandelbrot set. So that's a classical fractal, and there is a variant of it which is called the burning ship. And that fractal is almost the same formula as Mandelbrot, just an absolute applied on the X and Y, and it gives you, when you look at the big picture, it gives you that, and then when you zoom in at this place, you have this shape. But I've diverged a bit from the initial formula, and I've modified a bit the Y over time, which makes it look like it's actually burning, because that's called a burning ship, but it's a static formula, so I diverge a bit from it and make it collapse. So yeah, I think I need to find actually it needs to be red like that, it needs to be blue like that, so I'm close to a good palette, I think. Oh yeah, when something burns, it becomes black, so everything makes sense. It's already in this formula, it's already a ship, everything has been designed. Oh, that's a nice, I quite like this palette. Maybe it could fade to that, because at the beginning it's not really burning, and yeah, but that's... Yeah, this will be too much. Oh wow, that's nice. I really like this tone. And with the persistence moving effect we have above, that really adds to the effect. So yeah, I think we can. We want to make it quickly. Quickly. Maybe it should fade to zero, to that value. Smoothly, slowly, and maybe it's too much after that. Yeah, it's too much after. And what would that change? Because I just picked random value and fall on a good one. I think that's not what we want. Maybe it's a bit more gray. No, I prefer before. I'm not sure actually. And by the way, these numbers are just, it's just like a seed. You give a seed to your palette and then just give you a palette. But there is no sense into, yeah, don't try to think what these numbers mean. That don't mean much. Because when you look at the formula, it's it's actually a bit complex, but it's the one from IQ, from Inigo. So yeah, we can find it online. I think I usually add a link attached to it every time I take something from some place, but yeah, I forgot to put it in here. So yeah, so how do we make the time fade into from 0 to 0.1? Yeah, I'm thinking about exponential function maybe, or I mean, why not? Oh, okay. I shouldn't use that. Just gonna use this mouse. So we want the time. So I don't know the total. Like here, yeah, it's still not. It is. It's still showing. I mean, we want it to collapse at some point. It's still, it's maybe not fast enough. Maybe it should make it a bit faster. What? Why has the color changed? Oh, okay. Oh, I saved. Yeah, I guess 0.3 is nice. Because we waited that long on the page and it was still showing up. At some point it really should disappear, so yeah. It's not Saturday, yeah, sorry for that. I couldn't wait, but actually it's my first stream ever, so just wanted to check everything is good. Palette function is about to find a color scheme. Yeah, so Inigo. So yeah, we have a formula that gives you a nice variety of palettes. I mean, it gives you a really convenient function you can use to generate a lot of palettes, and then every time, I think I used literally in every shader I wrote in this series of shaders, and each time I'm just trying different numbers, so that's why I think we need some kind of generators that you scroll through and at some point you find what you want. But yeah, that just modulate. I think the two last parameters are the important ones. And what's interesting is like if you give it's equidistant values here, so 0.33 and 0.66, it's just gonna give you the classical U palettes, I guess. With the value of 1 for this one. So yeah, I mean, in a way, it's not a random function. They just throw in that. It still makes sense. But yeah, it's hard to figure that this produces this. Like, that doesn't look really logical or does not make a lot of sense. But maybe there's a, I don't know, a way to visualize or to explain it. But I didn't really understand it. So, okay. So I'm thinking I want a formula that would converge to one. I mean, converge to. I mean, I can just do max of my value and yeah, it can be as simple as that, or maybe. Oh, not, that doesn't look like what I want. I think I don't remember how to do this. Is it like ah? Yeah, I think usually we do that. Yeah, but I don't really want to make it. It can just fade linearly. That's fine. So yeah, I mean, whatever is. Yeah, it doesn't need to be that smart. I think it can just be take the mean of 0.1 because I just want to grow up to 0.1. So yeah, something like so that will be 100 seconds, yeah. Okay, that's good enough. So yeah, we have our burning ship. I think that's good enough for today's shader. So just to sum up, basically we have Mandelbrot. Mandelbrot is a pretty well-known fractal, but on top of Mandelbrot, if we do apps in just that part, in terms of changes, we have the burning ship, which is another known fractal. And what I did today is just diverging a bit the y value on that parameter, and that makes actually the ship burning. I mean, not really the burning animation we see here, but that makes the shape is collapsing a bit, and this animation is done by another shader that is just accumulating the shader it takes input, it accumulates it, and instead of just mixing colors, it's gonna look up in a small different place of the previous accumulated buffer, and the way I look up it is by changing a bit the x, so that's why we have a moving left and right effect, and also a y why oh, it's difficult tonight. I cannot think anymore. Translation, I will find my words. Alright, so yeah, I think we could make it bigger, but that's artistically, we don't want to put too much into it, that will be overkill. I think it's already too much, but maybe I can control, I can tweak that. Yeah. Oh, if we will see, we see red on the bottom part, which we are not seeing because of the fact I'm moving things up. So it's actually the whole thing is was not intended but accidental. And yeah, I was trying to fade in and out for making it. Is that, you know, it's like when you have flames, it tends to flicker a bit. Maybe you should have a bit of that effect, like doing chook 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 chook, some pops. Yeah, like that, but that's too much. It's not. I mean, for a small flame, I think we have that effect, but not for a big. If we are talking about a burning ship, it will not do that. Ah, that's odd. The effect is too much, indeed. But maybe we should offset more. Yeah, but if I offset more, it's gonna be even more blurry. It's not easy to figure out the good. Yeah, not that much. Yeah, I mean, you would have asked me yesterday, I wouldn't know about this fractal neither. I discovered it this morning, so. Yeah. I started, that was my first, 2 days ago, it was my first implementation ever of Mandelbrot. I never did it before, so I'm falling in the trap of just doing fractals now every day. So I mean, why not? But I try to have so try to do different things. We'll see over the. We'll see what we can do. Yeah, it's not enough. It's not fast enough in this part. But it needs to needs to have randomness. Cosinus is not it shouldn't just go left and right. Maybe this is going to be a mess. But I never really understood how we. I know we can, but I don't remember how to make using cosinus and sinus, or I mean a combination of them, or adding them up, or not adding them up, but more like multiplying them, or that to produce this kind of a bit randomness. Because the effect is too obvious, left, right, left, right, left, right. And yeah, it's. Yeah. Needs randomness. The Perlin noise, but that's overkill for us. For sure, we can. Because if I put a huge number, it's just gonna go to, yeah, go randomly left or right, and that's not what I want either. But it can have a slow one and adding up another one. That's a possibility, and I usually need to give a different weight. That is faster. Let's make it. All right. So yeah, in terms of it's too fast. Can use another phase. Five. Yeah, like there is some wind, so there is a general wind that is a bit slower than another perturbation that is faster. So that's the left and right effect, and then yeah. I think it's just easier for the putting that in a variable will be better. Call it offset. Right, yeah, the problem of Mat30. Well, wait. Yeah, the problem is if using Mat30 would. It will be 60 frame per second, so it needs to go without breaking in like in term of evolution. It needs to go That random will just make you jump from one value to another. So it's just gonna be pure noise, like pure white noise. We need to have it a bit more smoother. So yeah, we can smooth it. I mean, then Perlin noise is essentially that. Perlin noise is going to be a smooth, like some kind of smooth random, but with some like local minimas or and interesting ones. So gives you a bit some interesting patterns. So usually we would use that. Because here, if I just do a mat random, we just okay. So here it's just the up effect. So we can increase it to see it better. But the fact is, it's doing sometimes more or less. So here we see a bit. It's a bit weird, but I mean it works in a way, in its way. And if we do. If we do a cost, we have phases. Yeah, this is a bit more fuzzy. I mean, a bit more in its way. It's why not? It's doing the work. Yeah, that's a good. Yeah, but yeah, I mean, for that effect, the we want, which is a bit more chaotic. It could work. Yeah, all right. I think that's good enough. I want to make another shader so I can prepare more days, because that's just 2 days. That's just the shader of the day. But I want to prepare tomorrow, because maybe we'll not have that much time tomorrow. So just gonna continue on another shader. So yeah, maybe I should call it the real burning chip, because real burning chip. Alright, so another shader. Yeah, I think I will continue. If I continue another fractal, which I think I will, I'm just gonna keep that persistence, because we need it for preventing a glitch we see by rendering the thing, and when we move a bit in the fractal, we have glitches because we don't do anti-aliasing. So we will have issues if we don't find ways to do anti-aliasing. So or find a, I mean that's applying a blur or whatever. No offset for now. Hop. The end of the burning chip. Yeah. It looks like Notre Dame, or like Eiffel Tower or whatever. Eiffel Tower on a burning ship. Not really Eiffel Tower, but whatever. It's quite impressive that from a simple formula we generate that. Okay, so undoing that and zooming. I'm just gonna remove the offset and do the rotation and do the flipping. And if I remove that, we should have Mandelbrot again if it reloads. Doesn't reload. What's going on? isn't it? Oh, okay, so there is a bug in the I mean, there is a sub-optimization. I'm doing twice the apps, so I'm just gonna remove one line. So yeah, removing that apps will give us back the Mandelbrot. Yes. So either I do random thing again, or I just try to find another known fractal. I don't know. Maybe I can do random things. I mean, I can apply a function because we were seeing the apps one. Maybe there's another idea, like fract. I like exploring weird things. Yeah, okay, so in a way it makes sense because the fract is returning the fractional part of a value. So we see some bucket of, I guess, of one. Yeah, that makes sense. Fract of x. Is it its name fract? I don't know. No. Oh, I guess that's just this under. Yeah. No, it's not. I don't know how to do that in this mode, but. Okay, I don't know. What is this? Oh, it's a division. Oh, fraction, okay. Anyway, I don't know how to express it in that tool. But it's like you will see some teeth, a sawtooth shape. Sinus? Nothing. To change the amplitude, not the frequency. Yeah, nothing really interesting. That's, I think, yeah. I mean, there's the shape, but there's nothing special about it. Because it's between minus and one and one. Yeah, I don't think it's really interesting to use sinus. Yeah, because I'm around the same value if I do that, so. Yeah, it's not. It's glitching too much from the initial. I'm just still surprised about the apps. Like, how would just doing apps, absolute apps on that part would just do the other thing? But yeah, it's accumulative, so. It's the Fontaine. That's the Fontaine fractal. If I rotate. Yeah, I want to take a look, closer look at that one. Zoom quilt, what is that? Oh, that's nice. I wonder if in Mandelbrot do you have a recursion? Like, can you find again the same place you were coming from? I don't even know if this exists in Mandelbrot or if people have discovered some, but potentially. I was looking at some YouTube video where people have recorded for 10 minutes a Mandelbrot zoom. Yeah, it's quite trippy. It's really, really interesting. Okay. Oh yeah, actually, I think I remember that that one. Yeah, the problem with Mandelbrot Zoom, and I was explaining a bit before, but and I've actually tried empirically to how much you can zoom, and at some point you get into floating precision. Even though I'm in IP, I'm still gonna reach it. So I think I was zooming up to that or something like that. Yeah, something like 500,000. And we were seeing some glitches. I mean, you start seeing the pixels basically on your effect. What am I doing? So that's a Fontaine. It's a Fontaine fractal. Ibex on a Mandelbrot. Yeah, I actually was thinking about something quite similar. The using a fractal to generate the initial state maybe of a cellular automaton that is not as crazy as the game of life, obviously, but some cellular automatons that diverge from it. I think I definitely want to try something around this idea. And yeah, the Ibex game I made a few years ago was implementing some waterfalling, and you express it in a cellular automaton way. So you express if you have water on top, then I create water. If I have a flame on the bottom, then I create flame with a bit of randomness, and then you get into a very interesting simulations. So maybe there is an idea into that, yeah. Combining a fractal with So yeah, I mean, I was having some game of life fun in one of these shaders, but game of life is a quite simple and awesome cellular automaton, but it's not that realistic. I mean, it's a bit it's definitely chaotic. Why is it not centered? That's weird. Oh, I need to rotate after. Oh, but then it's on X. Ah, no, actually, that's good. What? Yeah, I want to zoom inside that shape. Alright, a bit more above. Whoa, it's like a giant. Oh, it is recursive. I can make my recursive loop, and I can cheat. I can cheat when as soon as I reach the same image, I switch to the previous one. But oh my God, what are these? What is happening? What is this object? Oh, there is smaller Batmans. Is this known? Is this fractal known? I don't know how this is actually. I introduce to you the Batman fractal. Batman contains. Okay. So wait, isn't this the initial shape? Don't remember. Yeah. So we have smaller, but we have the smaller fountain a bit above. Oh yeah, okay. Oh, it's actually just here. Alright, so let's recap a bit. Oh, this is known as a dark snowflakes. Dark snow flakes. I mean, I'm sure every shape you can make has been discovered by someone, that's for sure, but... Or did you just... okay. Let's buy some snowflakes. Alright. So this... yeah, now it's a crazy mess to try to figure out how to match the beginning with the end, but as soon as you figure this out, you just make a progress value between the two. And I need to figure out the zoom and in combination with the offset to make that the shape I want to match another shape. So I need to choose a starting point. I want it centered. So we'll keep that for later because that was an interesting zoom offset. Okay, yeah, this is like it's a global centering, I mean, it's a global position, so I need to actually choose it wisely. So I zoom so I don't have to even offset, I just have to zoom. But that needs to be pretty accurate. Okay. Meaning I will not see the... Oh, unless I unzoom, I can see the full shape. Okay, so I will have a lot of hard time to, I think, figure out the value of that one, but... it should be simpler apart from that. I think I'm just gonna screenshot that just to compare later because. Ah! Can I just. What the fuck is that? Ah, I can move it. Cannot. Okay, thanks, Mac. That's better. That's not working. Okay, I broke my... No, that's fine. Alright. What was it? This one? Yeah, whatever. Just keep it somewhere else. Sorry for that. We don't have the same. We will have differences. We have some other things around, but maybe we can fade them. I should probably stop doing the. Oh, I was no longer doing that. Okay. I mean, do we need that much iteration? I don't know. That's actually increasing the effect. Okay. I mean, let's keep it for now so we can see it better. And I think I need to find an interesting shape. But yeah, that's definitely the same shape. There's just more into it, more around. Wow. Oh yeah, okay. We are at the top of the fountain, in fact. So yeah, I can try to make this match. Yeah, there is definitely more noise, I mean more other effects around, but that's okay. I'm not centering it for now correctly, so actually I need to be centered at this. Yeah, I think that's somewhere here. Ten, something like that. Oh, okay, way more. So I'm not gonna do that. I'm not gonna do that every time. I'm just gonna flicker between two values over time. That's gonna be for now just a quick hack. Just gonna make it faster. Not that fast. Yeah, actually, it was just good, just perfect. Okay, it sounds like I got the zoom correct. More or less. Yeah, it's not gonna match perfectly. We have this other shapes around, but maybe I can tweak something. It's a bit different. It's a bit different. It's not exactly the same shape. So there's no perfect loop. And if I'm correct, my zoom is probably how do you say it? I'm losing my English, it's late. It's calibrated at a nice position. Isn't it the gold number? No, it's I don't. Is this a known number? I don't know. But whatever. I'm calibrating my number, and I think if I zoom again, it's just gonna be the shape at the same position. And maybe I should use a step one, and I should fade between step one and step two. There will be less difference. So, what am I doing? What was the number? 1.7. What is the good number? I never remember that one. Yeah, 1. Oh, okay. No, it's not that one. Yeah. All right. So, never mind. It looks familiar to me. Isn't it exponential of one? I don't know. Anyway, it's late. Nombre d'or, yeah. Should I double that zoom or it's not, maybe not, it's quadratic or whatever. I don't know. Ah, almost. 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 Maybe I. Remove one. What? Oh, yeah. I meant to do it after. No, it's. What? Oh yeah. It's on the one of the other. So wait, I'm on the correct zoom. It's just not the correct offset. Oh yeah, okay, I guess that makes sense. I don't get it actually. Never mind. I'm just gonna. And no, it's not. But if I move between 22 and 44, I can set that straight away from the beginning and need to figure out the other one. But actually, it's not a zoom issue. It's I mean, there is a zoom issue indeed, but there is also an offset issue. It's too much. No, not enough, in fact. Maybe I got it wrong. What am I doing? To zoom, zoom less. What is the ratio between the two? That's interesting. I would like to know it at the end. So, am I doing something really? Actually, I was on the same shape. So I'm not even zooming at the correct place, and I think we are zooming too much because I already see it. It's starting to get pixelized, so I think we will not take this idea. Yeah, it is definitely pixelized. We are already not zooming too much. So I'm gonna forget about that one, and yeah, we will have to figure out the. So yeah, back to plane to the first plane, to the first plan, and gonna figure out the way I do to morph between the two shape, or otherwise we just have a jump. I guess we can try. All right, so what should I do? I think maybe it's due to the iteration that I was having pixels, maybe. Yeah. Thanks, man. Or woman, I don't know, sorry. So it's a bit funny that it's not exactly the same. So that means in a way the fractal is never maybe Mandelbrot is not recursive. I mean, it's not looping. There's always this tiny changes, maybe. I don't know. Yeah. I'm curious about that. I will try to search online. I'm sure people have answered that question. Okay, so I want to fade between two values. This is a simple stuff. The thing is, should I overlap between my iterations? Should I overlap to make the overlapping smoothing a bit? I will not take care of this now, but I will try later maybe. Alright, so between 0.4 and 21. I mean, we're just gonna use mix. Let's do that for us. And that's gonna be pretty fast. And that's linear. So yeah, I think the zoom is when you zoom, you zoom on X and on Y. So that means it's not linear. If you the motion is not linear, it's it's reverse quadratic or whatever. So I guess we need to square root. No, wrong intuition. In a way, it's interesting. It's posing a bit. It's not what I want. It looks like a bat. It's a bat that is. But then I should. It's not centered, but. I should offset. But if I offset, I mess up the calculation. I should offset before doing the zoom. Yeah. So maybe I can just divide by zoom here before doing the okay. Yeah, but yeah, it's not center. Yeah, I mean, oh yeah, that's nice. Batman. Yeah. So this is a Batman. No, what was the name? Dark Snowflake. I thought about a fountain the first time, but. What if we do that? It's crazy. That's like motion blur. That's giving motion blur here. If I try that. If we put crazy motion blur, it's gonna be not really interesting. It's not looping, I mean it's not linearly zooming, so I don't really understand why, to be honest. Oh, it should multiply maybe. Yeah, because we start at 0.4, not at 1. And mixing is gonna linearly zoom. Yeah. That doesn't change anything. That's the same formula. Yes, that will not help. Yeah, that's better. Like that's my initial intuition was square root, but actually it's just the reverse of square root. It's and I was thinking, okay, maybe it's actually four, but it's not. So yeah, I don't really get it. Don't really get it, but that's okay. Oh, is it because this is between 0 and 1, the fract. Yeah, but that's not. Yeah. It's more or less. It's doing a small pause, that's okay, why not? Switch to another palette. Isn't it Batman color? But Batman's color is yellow like that, no? I don't remember. I don't remember at all what the color of Batman. Yeah, that's I mean that's not really the logo of Batman, but just randomly falling on a nice palette as usual. So when I want to debug a palette, what I do is I mix the color of my shader with. Yeah, it's a bit crazy. It's too fast. Alright, I'm gonna go really soon. It's already quite late. Not that late, but yeah, so it's only using the beginning or the ending. Yeah, the ending of like a small part of the palette, in fact, and the other are in the small glitches. So I want to remove the small glitches, meaning I want to only focus on part of that range. I was having a variable, I was not even. So yeah, I can just change the lookup. But then I just need to focus about one. Is it inside or is it outside? And that's it. I don't really need a fade. Yeah, that's it. So I think I just can step. Or just multiply. Yeah, but no, not gonna sell. But that means I just. I don't need to iterate a lot. What happens if I iterate really? Oh, okay, in the zoomed version, it's gonna be blurry. It's gonna be pixelized, I mean, not precise enough. Nice. Interesting. It's not that impressive at the end. I mean, it's just a small, basic fractal. I was just focusing on one part of the fractal. Maybe there were interesting other interesting parts. If we zoom in this, in the on top of the structures, I will try to take a look. Oh no, never mind. It's gonna take too much time. But I guess at some point I will look at that. Yeah, I don't know what makes it a bit more interesting, but it looks like more a bat if I if I put more motion blur because gives more. Yeah, sometimes there is shaders that are a bit slow and a bit more relaxed, but this one is a bit more have more strength or have more yeah, the fact it zoom in this particular position does make it looks like it's going down. I will need to offset instead of zooming. I mean offset at the same time if I would want to move it somewhere else, I guess. But no, it's not possible in fact. It needs to move out, to move down to disappear. Yeah. Can try a rotation. Oh, it's not correctly centered. And for making it centered, I need to rotate before the offset. I'm using fract of the time. So yeah, I need to make it. Oh, actually, this could work because it. Oh yeah, it's then it's moving at different places, but. The whole thing is no longer aligned because I would need to remove that. I think I'm making it even weirder, but. I like when we start doing it. This because you with the motion blur you actually it looks like you are doing no longer a fractal but how do you say it? Like you are rendering an actual parametric curve. It's not a parametric curve but it's just a really quickly rotating pretty fastly rotating shape. And with the motion blur, you get this. So I think I'm gonna do that over time. And I just wonder if I. At some. Yeah, it shouldn't be too much. Because then it starts to. It gets glitchy because you actually. Depending on your FPS, you are going to have differences, it's not going to be great. Yeah, it looks like a loader. It looks like a loader. Batman loader. And then it gets glitchier. So yeah, I really like it. And I think time squared like almost time time to the square of 2 is interesting because 40 is the current one, so it's gonna be 1 minute. Just need to be maximized. or maybe not. And 60 frames per second, that means there is a relation in that. Oh, not really, because there is pi. Oh, nice! It's an hexagon! Oh, it's a, it's like a star of Batman's. A queen. Star. Oh, yeah, it's like a queen's. Yeah, I like this ending, like that's the ending, and then the beginning is just gonna speed up more and more and more. I guess it needs to be... shouldn't get straight away into rotation. Not yeah, zero. So for 10 seconds we will not have the rotation, then it starts, but it starts pretty quickly, so yeah. it's better to slow it down, but maybe straight away. Yeah, but after some time, okay, so... for 2 seconds it doesn't rotate, then it starts rotating, and quite slowly at the beginning. And then it's getting crazy. So it's a nice one in terms of scenario. It's a nice, good enough. I want a better palette. I mean, it's quite basic. It's really fast, like the overall... I would like to use another technique I used in the previous shader, this one. It makes accelerate... it's an acceleration value from 0 to 1, and you can slow down things at the beginning, so maybe I should do that. Oh shit, what's going on? My coloring is... syntax highlighter is down. oh, I was not doing what I was doing. It was not the correct place. I just modified it. Yeah. I guess that's it, and the time is used here. The rotation. What does the what? Oh oui. Occidental. That's a zoom. So the maybe the zoom. Yeah, it's a nice start because we have nothing at the beginning and then okay, it starts loading, slowly starting. What is that? What is? Oh, okay, it boosts. It looks like it boosts every time. Yeah, that's the problem. It's not linearly zooming. Oh, because of that. Yeah. No, it's not a problem. Okay, that's cool. All right, so let's go back to my palette. I still wonder if I shouldn't just keep the let the F flows. Ah, yeah, it doesn't help on the shape. So then it's just about two values and we just can define a value. Because the palette is actually one color now, we don't need to. Sounds like we can just pick one of the color we want and that's it. From the initial palette, the classical one that have all the colors, we can just offset. And I think we can offset with the time. But it's, then it's quite classical, there is nothing. It could change really, really, really slowly. On 1 minute. Oh, no, not 1 minute 5. That's something like really slow. And then we want yellow as a start. Yellow. Actually, I want another palette. It's not. Let's try to find a nice palette that have a lot of yellows. Wow, I've been streaming for 2 hours. Oh my god. I mean, Dark Mad, the Batman is like blue and white. I mean, at night time, it's a blue and that works. That could work. I just wonder about can we make it different, more contrasty. We need a gray tone. What is going on? What just happened? Why is he doing that? Is it just because of the I don't know why it's doing that now. It makes no sense. This shader should be called No, I'm Batman. I don't understand just joke. I don't understand why it start doing that by just the palette, because I'm still using step. Maybe I have to. What? Oh, I have minus one, I forgot about this one. So many Batmans. I don't get it. No, I'm Batman. So many Batmans. Ah, okay. Oh my god. No, that's me. I get it. Okay, no, that was used. Alright, makes no sense why I need to. Maybe just gonna let it flows. That's better because I mean we see it's Mandelbrot in a way. We see the snowflakes pattern. It's just not looping anymore. That's a bit annoying, but that's okay. I mean, it gives. Ah yeah, it's. It's hard to focus, it's hard to look at that shader when it's doing that, it's that's bad. But then at some point it will start be so fast that it's good, but I think it needs to increase by steps. Because it's not really interesting to rotate too fast. But if you have steps, it's or it needs to be really fastly, suddenly. Yeah, I mean that's steps. That's what steps are going to do. So I guess I can try to floor. Why is it that slow? I was supposed to be rotating quite fast after 16 seconds. No, it's not fast. I mean 60 max. Oh, okay. I mean, I don't really need that anymore because I've been using that, so. And I'm still not using the, I mean, yeah, I disabled the persistence, so it's gonna be great, it's gonna be great. Yeah, I'm not sure about one thing. Not sure about that. We cannot use that stepping because it's jumping at random rotations. Actually, it's getting quite fast now because I was just not using the correct formula. So yeah, no problem. Yeah, thanks to that. What happens if I put it a lot and then maybe I can just fade away to that? Yeah, then it's... It's like... At the end there's just... dust. Yeah, I think it needs to increase. To something really high. Up to that point and... I think that's it. I just don't know about the coloring. Oh, it's green. Oh, yeah, because I... Wow. That's nice. Yeah. Oh my god, that's getting really good now. Like suddenly just changing some parameters and now it's like great. I don't like this blue. This is too... Yeah, I don't like when it does that. Why is it blue now? What? There were other colors now, before. What? It's supposed to rotate. Now there's yellow at the beginning. I think it needs to be slower. Sorry, it's not gonna be no, I'm Batman. I mean, it's not, is this really gonna be Batman? It no longer looks like a Batman at this point. It looks like a weird tunnel. But yeah, still at the beginning, it's Batman. Oh, it's just a fountain. Now we need the hardcore bits, yeah. It's like a rotating. It's a vinyl. If I should make it sometimes like go back to slowing down and but I like when things move the way to a state that is at the end is really almost not moving. I like that as well. That could be done with this persistence. I just want to check what happens. Yeah, that's nice. Oh. Oh my God, that's great. Look at that. Oh my God, that's so cool. What is going on? I will not touch any parameters. That's like the perfect persistence. Just this is going to be some kind of Easter egg. I mean, if you really wait a long time, so what long time is that? I don't know. Maybe 2 minutes, 3 minutes. Yeah, 2 minutes is already a lot. You really have the time to see it coming, that's quite a lot of time, but I mean, why not? That's quite good. Alright, that's good for the shader of tomorrow, and we have the shader of today. It's already late in France, so it's already late for the shader of today. The shader of tomorrow is gonna be, I guess, tomorrow night as well, so I can make it. Oh, I really like when it was red. It was red at the beginning though. But at some point it's gonna be red again. I'm not sure about the palette to be honest. But yeah, whatever. That's good enough. It's quite fast. It's going too fast in moving into that state, I feel. At the beginning, it shouldn't rotate. It should just wait before doing that. That's what I initially planned, but then I messed up with my function. So I think I'm gonna do a zooming, rotating. And it starts at 20 seconds. It's annoying. To me, it's a bit annoying when the phase during at the beginning of the rotation doesn't need to be too long. But that also means we will not have the nice timing. Unless I remove that. 20. Okay. That's making it. I really like when it gets red into the red style, the red radiance. It's getting really fast into the thing, but it's like. I think I want to randomize the initial color so it gets into different colors. But yeah, I'm not sure about the palette. Yeah, it's not a good palette. Fall on it a bit randomly, but. It makes not a lot of sense because. What am I doing here? Oh, yeah, I'm offsetting the palette. So it's a static palette at the end, and it's just I'm offsetting it. So. I like this red, that's for sure, but I just don't want a green. Green makes no sense. I used to have blue. I was playing with the, oh yeah, I was playing with that and yeah, that's nice, but I want it to be a bit different. No. Okay, that's why. Okay, so it seems like I'm losing the red if I go there. Okay, why? That parameter is really changing a lot when you touch it. I like that. I want to see that happening. I think it's a great palette. This is starting with red. Oh no, what was this in? I don't remember this was in my palette. This pink, but I can still offset to whatever value. And it all started with Mandelbrot, but yeah, I think it's. I think I will be. I'm stuck in the let's do just fractals in that shader day, in that one shader a day series. I think I will be stuck in that for a few days still. But I mean, I always try to explore things I never did before, so that's for sure that I never did. Such shaders. So yeah, we'll continue exploring that. I was I want to do a cross mixing different concepts. So yeah, definitely remarching, like 3D remarching and Mandelbrot. I want to explore that. Cellular Automaton and Mandelbrot. Versus Mandelbrot, so yeah, I think there is an interesting exploration around this. So yeah, I think we are pretty great with this one, and I believe after 2 minutes, it's going to fade to something. Where you almost not see the shape and you just see it like heart beating a bit from the mid, from the center, which is quite interesting. So yeah, it's getting really yellow. I remember we have that in our palette at some point. It's really, really white. I need to see the palette again. Oh, it's getting blue after that. Oh, but I'm seeing the palette with the with the accumulation of pixels. That's not good. It's not seeing the palette. Anyway, cold blue. So yeah, initial state is not good. Yeah, I wanted another one. That's what I was doing. At the beginning, you see it's not looping correctly, and I don't really know how to fix that anyway. Unless I do a different mapping at the beginning based on the time. Mixing. Zooming? No, or rotating in fact, because that's relating to rotating. Yeah. When it's one, it's gonna be F. Oh, it's nice when it's blue. Yeah, but. Why? Oh, it means it's. Oh, maybe I'm doing it reversely. No, ah, okay. Oh, yeah, I'm doing it reversely. Alright, so when it starts rotating, we will introduce more colors. That way, we don't really see the fact it was not perfectly looping. And then we enter this craziness. One thing I didn't really play with is the acceleration of the zooming. So many tweaks into all of that. I just put a random value at some point here, at just half of the time. If I make it crazy, I don't know if it would be crazy. Oh! Yeah, but it's. Why is it doing that? Oh, okay. So at the end we have a spiral of Batman. if we accelerate too much. Maybe we can enter enough. No, that's gonna be too much into the effects. But it can be interesting to tweak that. It can be interesting to. It's like if we really want it slow, that's really nice. This can be changed over. This can change over time with the cosinus this time. Point 0.5. 0.5 was already quite fast. Hmm. can try with the time, but that's gonna be good. Wow. So one is already doing that. Oh yeah, it's not. No, no, no. It's going back and forth. Yeah. Oh, exempt flat tail. What is going on? It's like, oh no, what did I do? Oh, okay, I'm closing the. No, yeah, maybe I can switch between two values, 0.2 and then suddenly 0.8. No, it's weird. If I change between two values. But this is quite good enough. So we increased from the 0.5. That's one possibility, but maybe not. I think it's nice if it's actually slowing, pretty slow to zoom in. That makes it more like a tunnel you are diving into. That's too fast. But, I want to call it a queen. Queens. But wait, I already called one twins. Queens. I already had a shader called queens. So no, it's not queen. It's not gonna be queens. It's gonna be fountains. Let's call it. I like your joke. I'm gonna call it. No, I am. It's a fight of Batman's. No one, everyone's fighting for to be the Batman. And actually, there's just one. It's just rotating. And it doesn't go that fast in this state. And in terms of timing, I finish rotating at 30. I end that 20 seconds, 20. Right, so at 40, I'm done. So there's 20 minutes, 20 seconds before the 1 minute slot. So I think actually it makes sense I do that. And then we get to that state after 1 minute, which was really nice when it was red. But I don't see red in my palette anymore. It's a bit disappointing. Okay, stop doing any persistence on that. Okay, I have no red. I have no red anymore. Which I would like. I hate these parameters. In fact, it's impossible to tweak the one of these in this vector. So I think this one. All right, that's the direction I like. Nope. I should make it use the Xbox controllers just with some axis playing with the stick to find the good values. Oh yeah, okay, nice. Ah yeah, I don't. It's hard to find a good color. Also, I don't really know what I want, so that's a bit of a problem. Yeah, we need a generator. We need a generator palette or something. I don't know if it's that article is popular from IQ, but maybe I'm the most user of that palette, but I use it everywhere. I'm the biggest user. And I'm diverging to something really awful. I think it was 8 here and don't remember. I need to mess with that. Yeah, I like this one a lot. Normally, there's not a lot of pink in the palette, but since it's at the beginning, that's where we were starting on. Yeah, there is white that is messing with the thing because. Set. I think I had red at some point. Alright, let's make it super fast. Okay, we have blue. Okay, yellow. That's gonna be the start, like before. It's gonna start with yellow. This needs to rotate on a 60 seconds. What, there is green? Why is there green? What is going on? It's not a fract. It's not the same as fract. I always thought it was doing the same. Okay, so I guess let it diverge to whatever. But why not? After 1 minute, it gets into weirder palettes. That's okay. At least I like the initial palette, but. Okay, so if we graph something wider than the 0, 1 range, it's gonna. Loop. Oh, okay. I never knew that. Oh, it's looping if you don't touch that parameter. It starts looping. It's no longer looping. So that parameters give a different coloring over time, over the numbers. I mean, over the. The integer values, which is a nice property, but I didn't design my thing to make it look like that. But yeah, it looks like it's okay. But I didn't. That's another palette. That's not the one I wanted. I didn't get it. What? Oh yeah, it's increasing time. Should we loop that in a fractional way? What? I'm a bit lost. I just don't know if it is work, but okay, we are staying in our palette, so that's nice. I want to start with yellow. That's not yellow. Yellow. I don't get it. Why is yellow? I really don't get it, to be honest. So yeah, I think I'm gonna stay with whatever initial value and that's it. I'm not gonna tweak it more. Just make it yellow. What is doing that? That means, okay, I have a nice big, so I think at least in the 1 minute, oh what? Oh, there were time spent, so I guess in the 1 minute range it's good. Going in that direction. Oh. Okay. Okay, I think that will be for tomorrow. All right, I think I'm done. I'm gonna sleep. Because it's already quite late. Thanks a lot, I guess that's just you, Mr. Speaker. Oh, I think that, I don't know how much, I don't even know how I can see that. But 3 hours of stream. I guess I'm good for Saturday's live, and yeah, I can try to make it a bit more focused on something than last Saturday. Yeah, this one was okay. I think I made 2 shader in. Oh, sorry for the feedback. Yeah, so yeah, I think I can make it. Yeah, so 2 shader in 3 hours, it's quite good, I will say, but I mean, it's quite simple stuff, it's not 3, it's not getting too much into craziness like last time. But yeah, I guess we'll see what I will do, but I think it's, wow, it's a nice effect. Yeah, I will see if I do some of the ideas I mentioned about mixing concepts, remarching Mandelbrot. I forgot to remove that. That's why it's not doing the final. Thanks a lot, and have a good day, have a good evening, have a good morning. And I forgot to record that to upload to YouTube at some point, but I think that's how you do it, because otherwise you will lose, I think you will lose your stream, but that's okay, that was the first try. Good night, thanks.